Philip. You're gonna have a heart attack.
This video is so hard for me to make because I don't like talking about myself. And yet I have to because someone is sitting there right now who this video I know can relate to. So let my toxic relationship hopefully benefit you in some way, shape, or form. 4 years I have been in a relationship. I poured my life, poured my love, my time, my energy. I poured so much of me into it. Recently, just abruptly came to an end, like a hard stop. This relationship was a job that I truly love, yet it was toxic. I was a cycle instructor at a should-be trendy cycle studio. First instructor to ever teach 1,000. By far my favorite class I ever taught. Why did I quit? I've been in this manipulative, toxic, narcissistic environment. I stayed in that 4-year relationship because I thought I could help them change for the better. Guess what? It's never gonna happen with a narcissistic person because they are know-it-alls. They know everything. I am not making this video to bash the owners. I'm making this video because I know someone is in a similar situation and it's tearing them to shreds. Folks, I absolutely loved what I did, but it was a terrible environment. I could not stand who I was becoming and I realized I needed to cut this out of my life. What part of your life is not healthy? Do you have those? What are you doing about them? I put in my 2 weeks and my last day was supposed to be the day that I started. I mean, quit a 4-year job, start on the day and quit on the same date so it transfers to the 4th year. Genius, right? Yeah. I turned in my 2 weeks and the next day I came in for a class. I was greeted with a statement, "You're leaving when we need you the most." 8 words that just... I don't know about you, that would take me days, the weeks, the months to think of something so toxic, so manipulative, and then to say that to someone after they put 4 years into your organization. Final 2 weeks, I could not sleep more than 4 hours. My systolic blood pressure was in the 150s. That's stage 2 hypertension. At this stage of high blood pressure, doctors are likely to prescribe a combination of blood pressure medications and lifestyle changes. I lost almost 8 pounds. I relapsed in a behavior that I don't feel comfortable telling you because it's ruined so much of my life to begin with. 4 years I haven't relapsed, and I had a full-blown relapse. Yes, I've had lapses here and there. I've struggled with this most of my life. When you work in the fitness industry and struggle with the condition that I struggle with, everything you've worked hard for can be gone in an instant. I would lose all people's beliefs and trust if they found out. And we all have struggles. I've been so good. I've put myself in positions to never go down that route. Turning in that 2-week notice, just couldn't take it anymore. Why am I doing this to myself?
The day before my last class, which I was super pumped for, I was gonna make it into a party, a big goodbye event. I was moving on. The manager sent me an emotionally manipulative text trying to get me to teach 2 of their classes. I turned it down. I only wanted to teach my last 2 classes. Yet, the manager, being a manipulator, didn't like that. Instead, I received a text saying, "We replaced you with another instructor. You don't need to come. You are officially done."
As someone who's never been in a relationship, physical, romantic relationship with someone, I've poured out so much of my life into my jobs because I truly care about them. I don't believe in working in a job that you just go and collect a paycheck. That's wasting my life, wasting my time, wasting my energy, and I'm not gonna put a full-fledged effort in. And to be just tossed aside like a little toy? I've seen Toy Story 3. I don't know about you. What were those toys doing at the daycare? They were there because those people didn't want them anymore. Be thrown aside from a job that you absolutely loved. It was so stinking hard. And yet, this has been the best thing to happen to me. This negative event placed on me might have an impact on you. And that's why I'm shooting this trash video. I don't want to be sitting here. I feel like I'm about to make out with the camera. I've never been in a relationship, so I've not been this close with a lot of people. For 4 years, I stayed at this cycle studio because first off, I loved it. Second off, I was twisted. I was manipulated. I taught 1,000 classes. They tossed me out like a broken toy because the vehicle, me, we can get a new vehicle. The manager cut me out when she realized I couldn't benefit her anymore. She wanted me to teach her classes the previous day and I said no. I just want to teach my last two.
Oh, you're not a benefit to me anymore.
Manipulative people are not really interested in you except as a vehicle to allow them to gain control so that you become an unwilling participant in their plans.
Goodbye.
Adios.
Sayonara.
I'm making this video because I don't want you to be drawn into a toxic relationship, a manipulative relationship, a narcissistic relationship, and maybe you can find...
Wait, this sounds like what Philip said.
Or I need to check out those links down below.
Use me
as an instrument, not do what I did.
Are you in a situation?
Are you still there? What are you waiting for?
What, you think that's gonna get better?
4 years.
I was going to get better the whole time.
Look where I'm at now. I'm sitting in front of a camera about to make out with it
and pretty rough situation
with no closure.
Read those links.
Knowledge is power. Trust me, I probably would not have stayed for 1,000 classes if I realized what I was dealing with and realized that my job was killing me. After quitting, I struggled with zero closure, yet I found closure in many different ways. A family who had been going to my classes for 4 years stopped at another gym and gave me this card. This card is simple. It was the closure I needed. An instructor who happened to be a counselor that quit the week before gave me that hug that I needed.
Since quitting, my systolic blood pressure has gone down 30 points to the normal levels. Regained most of the weight I lost. I sleep a full night. It's awesome. Relapse is no longer a word in my dictionary. It's called recovery and progress.
Folks, I'm excited for you to let go. I'm not telling you to quit a job. No. I'm not telling you to break up. No. Read those links below. Find out what is manipulation. What is narcissism? And decide, is your job, is your relationship, is it taking you down a negative path straight into the ground? Or is it uplifting you?
To end, I just want to read off a little quote. Regularly examine what you believe. We don't do this enough. As life progresses, our beliefs and attitudes may change. And we need to know how these changing ideas affect us. When we are not sure what we believe, it's all too easy to allow someone else who's sure that their beliefs are right, not only for them, but for you as well, to attempt to manipulate your thinking.
Life is too short to stay in a terrible situation. Toxic. Do you want to look back on your life and say, I stayed there for all this time for what?
The grass is not always green on the other side.
Yet sometimes we need to step out of our comfort zones. When you look down and see, is that mud underneath your feet, poop, or are you actually on grass? If you're not on grass, why are you staying there? I don't know about you, I'm walking away. I let it go, I'm free!